So you need to make some extra money in 2019, and you're looking for a way to do that. So what we're going to talk to you today about is how you can do that quick and easy and ethically by helping people with skills that you already have. My name is Kathy McReynolds. I am your fun, money, and skill coach. Guys, as you come on, say hello so I can say hello back to you. And let me know if you have a skill or talent that you know that you can teach and help other people with, because that's what this is about today, helping you to understand that online you can actually make money and have people and help people learn something that you already know very, very well. You don't have to be perfect at everything, but there's this one skill, this one technique, this one item that you know more than most people or just as good as, and you can teach it and help other people. And guess what? They're going to pay you for that. So if that's you out there, maybe you're on the end where you want to teach, or maybe you want to learn. But I'm going to speak today to the people who actually want to teach a course, a training, anything that will help someone. It could be a challenge, anything that will help someone increase their skills. People will pay you. People pay to learn things. That's why you go to school, right? I want you to think about it this way. Why do you pay to go to college? Because you're paying to go to college so that you can get a certificate saying that you know something, or you can get more experience. And so here's the great thing that I love about being online and being an entrepreneur. You get to learn from people who have done what you want to do. You get to learn from people who've actually experienced it. And I'm not poo-pooing college, but a lot of times they teach just from theory, and they can't tell you the most important part of winning at any game that you need to do. If you want to be an entrepreneur, there is one key tip, which I'll tell you guys at the end, that regardless of the tips that I'm going to give you today, if you don't possess this one key thing, I don't care what you know, you won't be successful as an entrepreneur, because it takes time and it takes a certain thing to have to make that happen. So let me go ahead and dive into the tips. And as you come on, again, don't forget to say hello. Let me know where you're tuning in from. And guys, if you find value or you know someone who wants to create courses, challenges, or make money online, make sure you do me a favor and go ahead and share this. So I'm going to jump into those tips for you. So you can earn money by helping people. Number one, you want to discover what your target audience will pay you in order to help them. And so what do I mean by that? You gotta figure out, okay, so maybe you're a closer. You are so good, no matter what you do, whatever field that you're in, you know how to sell and close someone. You know how to get that money. You know how to get that paycheck. And the reason why you know how to do that is because you use a certain system or a certain skill. So you can take what you do best and you can turn that into a course or a challenge. So what is it, and who else would like to have that skill? That's how you got to look at that. And number two, guys, once you do that, you got to do the research on it. Figure out the research. And when I say research, you want to find out who's already doing what you're doing. There's nothing new under the sun. There's nothing new online. So do your research to see who is doing what you're doing. And then identify, number three, why are they dominating at it? Why are they good at what they do? I look in the multi-level marketing industry and I think of, Ray Higdon, and he's been online for about 9 years, but he talks about when he first came online, he was going through foreclosure. He was, not winning. He was not at the best place in his life, but what he kept doing was being consistent, and he started to research and looking at the people and who was doing what. And what he did was he became consistent at it, and he found a way to go from being a nobody to actually dominating that industry, because he knew where he wanted to go. He knew how he was going to get there, and he just relentlessly went after it with that key that I'm going to tell you guys is when you stick around to the end. And then number three, guys, you got to identify where they're dominating at. Are they dominating on Facebook? Are they dominating on Instagram? Are they dominating on LinkedIn? Where are they dominating at? Where are they getting all of their growth and resources from? And then number four, important, study their market copy. Study what they're saying. Study how they're saying it, their sales system and their frame. Like, how are they framing it? What is their sequence of what they're doing? I'm constantly going through and saving ads that I see. I'm saving people who, I see that have a lot of followers. And so you go through and you write down different tips that you get, and you look at their comments from people that are commenting on what they're saying. I'm like, okay, so why are they saying that? What did they say? What do you like about this? Okay, so what steps are they using? What is their system? How are they framing what they're doing? You want to mirror. It's no different than someone who's playing sports. When they're playing sports, they talk about how they'll get the film. They'll get the film of their game or the top person's game, and they watch it over and over and over again. They'll watch that film and they'll see exactly what they're doing, and then they're like, okay, that move. Okay, so here's what he does on this play. And so, okay, and they're taking notes, and then they go and they practice that. That's the same thing. If you want to dominate online, like, that's what I do. My goal is to dominate online. So you want to make sure that you're mirroring and studying people and doing your research. You just can't get on here and like, okay, yeah, I'm going to hop on, I'm going to do it live, I'm going to do that. No, there's so much more behind this. So you want to make sure that you do that. And then here's step five. Everybody does it. Boxing, sports, find their weakness. Find their weakness and how you can get in and then make that weakness your strength. Make that weakness your strength. Find their weakness so that you can dominate. Take them out. Yes, if you want to be number one, you got to be thinking that way. Like, how can I take them out? How can I bring more value? How can I position myself so that I can dominate and take out the number one spot? Now, if you just want to make a little extra money, you don't have to go through all of this. You could just say, hey, I'm teaching a course in my group. Here's the cost. You can pay me on Messenger. It could be that simple. But if you want to build a lasting business, you have to strategically do it. Number six, see what's selling and why. Why is it selling? So you see it. Now, why is it selling? Why are people looking for that? What results? What does the end look like? What are they going to experience from the end results from that happening? Once you see what the end results are you willing to put in the work to give them that end results? Do you see it happening? It is so, let me just tell you, like, it's so rewarding when you know that you take the time to help someone out and you see them growing because you put in that effort to do that. So you can make that happen. And then number seven, guys, what type of clients are getting the results? You can't help everybody, and you got to decide what type of clients. Do you want to have clients where, they're spending between $0 to $100, or do you want to have clients that they're spending between $1,000+, $1,000 to $3,000, $3,000 to $5,000, $5,000 or beyond. Make that decision as to who you want to serve, because once you know who you want to serve, if you want to serve, if your target market is for people who will pay you $100, then it's going to take a lot of people for you to make a six-figure income. But if your target market is for you to serve people who will pay you $3,000 to $5,000 to help them grow. And you think about that. People, like, it's a mental mindset that people need to think about, because here's the key. If you want to go to college and you want to learn something, you're going to spend between $15,000 to $20,000 if it's a junior college. In most cases, at a public college, it's like $40,000 for those 4 to 5 years and $50,000+ in a private college, just to get out and position yourself to make on average between $50,000 to $70,000, because that's what the average of America, and that's combined income. So position yourself and ask yourself, who do you want to serve? Yes, you are valuable in your resources and what you have, that yes, you could charge someone $3,000. Because if you charge someone $3,000 and they make $100,000 and that's a $97,000 increase, is that worth it to them? So you first have to decide yourself that you have enough knowledge to teach people to get somewhere. Now, a lot of people, here's the key. People go up and down in business. And before they hit that all the way up, I want you to know that even if you've been up and then you came down, what you have mastered is the ability to get there. Where the challenge is the ability to keep it. So that's a whole different skill set. You know, if you've made over a six-figure income in your life, you know how to get there. So that means you know how to teach someone to get there. So that means that if you didn't keep it, you got to find someone to help you to learn how to keep it. But that doesn't stop you from teaching someone else how to get there. So you got to remove those thoughts from your head and make sure that you get to that next area. And then, guys, number eight is, how will you offer what you want to offer and be good at it and be the best at it? How will you offer that and be the best? Are you going to offer it through group coaching? Are you going to do it one-on-one? Are you going to have retreats? Are you going to have webinars? Like, you have to decide how you're going to make that offer. And then number five, offer your coaching package and tailor it to your dream client. Who is your dream client? You deserve to get paid for what you're worth. And because of that, you got to make that decision as to who you want to help. And just remember, you're not meant to help everybody. You want to help the people that you know you can create the most results from. And when you create the most results, it'll allow you to get testimonies. And when you can get testimonies, it'll allow you to help some more people. And when you help more people, they win, you win, everyone is successful. So I hope those tips helped you. And as I said, I told you all of those tips, and none of them will mean anything unless you possess the key to winning in business. And the key to winning in business, guys, as I told you, if you stuck around to the end, is you got to possess this one thing that most people don't possess. And that's why most people don't end up becoming and staying in the entrepreneurship world. They'll go back and they'll get a job and they won't do it, because they don't possess this one thing. And this one thing that I'm talking about is mental toughness. You must be mentally tough to win in this world as being an entrepreneur. It is not for the faint of heart. It is not for people who get their feelings hurt easily. It takes time to build something up. Yes, I titled this, "You Can Make Money Quickly," because you can with a short course. You can with a short challenge. You can make a little money. But if you want to change your life and have significance, you want to create a signature course for yourself, and it must start at $1,000 and above. And trust me, there are people out there who will pay you for that. But if you ain't mentally strong and you're not mentally tough, you're not gonna last long enough to get to that point of creating your signature course. So I believe in you. I know you can do it. You just gotta be mentally tough and strong. And until you can get there by yourself, surround yourself with people who are. If you have not already, make sure you join our group, the Fun and Freedom Movement, where we will help you with going live. And also, we're starting this year to help you create courses and challenges. And I will also be offering my signature coaching program to people who want to take their income to that six figure and beyond from teaching and helping people, and have courses that they're charging $1,000 and plus for. So if that's you, if that's something that you want to do, make sure you go ahead and message me because I'm putting that together. It'll be out next week where we're going to start looking for people who want to go to that next level, who know they got something significant in them and they're ready for the world to know that. I want to help you get that message out, and we're going to help you rock it and make it happen. All right, guys, this is Kathy McReynolds, your Fun, Money, and Skill Coach. If you got value or you know someone else who may get value from this, do me a favor. Go ahead and hit that share button. Drop in the comments and let me know, what are some of your skills? What would you teach? What is stopping you? What are some of the fears that you have that maybe like make you feel uncomfortable with charging $1,000 plus for the knowledge that you have? Or maybe you're ready to just get started and you want to do a mini course or a challenge, you know, a 10-day or 21-day or 30-day challenge. We also have a package that's coming out for that. I want to know how I can serve you. That is my job, to help you grow and win and become the person that inside you want to be. And trust me, guys, you don't want to do it by yourself. You want to shorten your learning curve and get around people who will believe in you and help you through the rough times as you're creating success for you and your family, so you can live the lifestyle you desire. Appreciate you guys. And you know, my thanks to you for tuning in, because as I, you know, said to my group earlier today, people have a choice as to who they listen to. So I appreciate the fact that you chose me today. And have a great day and have a great weekend. See you later. Bye-bye.